Gina Ditto, and I am a school teacher at UCSF Benioff Children's Hospital. And I bet a lot of you have been wondering where your friend Nathan has been over the past few months. Well, he hasn't been skipping class and he hasn't been on vacation. He's actually been here at the hospital with us because he was diagnosed with a brain tumor. And he's been here getting treatment as well as getting strong again so that he can come back to school.
My name is Dr. Amy Hautrau, and I'm a pediatric rehabilitation doctor. Nathan has a brain tumor. That's a kind of cancer. He's been in the hospital for a long time to try to take care of it. It was discovered several weeks ago and he had to have a surgery on his brain to take out that brain tumor. I'm gonna show you on a model of a brain what that looks like. So this is the brain, and if you imagine it in someone's head like my own, this part is the front, so where the face is. His brain tumor was in the back part of his brain, back in here. The surgery doctors were able to take it out, but that even though they took it out, there's still a lot of treatment that he needs to have. So he's been in the hospital receiving very special treatment with the oncology doctors. There's a special kind of x-ray therapy that they provide right in the area where the tumor was to try to make sure it doesn't grow back. And he also takes special medicine to try to make sure that that tumor doesn't come back. Having a tumor in your brain is not a good thing. It can cause lots of problems with the way your body works, how your thinking is, and how you're able to do things. So for Nathan, Nathan is tired more than other children are because of his treatment. His endurance for activities isn't as good. And he also has trouble controlling his body, but his thinking is very good, and he's very funny and very witty.
They are just monitoring what's going on in Nathan's brain to make sure everything's okay, make sure the tumor's not coming back, make sure there's no swelling in his brain.
Because he has trouble controlling his body, you'll notice some things about Nathan are different now. Right now he's using a wheelchair because he can't control his body well enough to be able to walk by himself. You might also notice that Nathan's arms move a lot in ways that he isn't trying to make them move. So sometimes when he's trying to reach for something, you might notice that his arm moves a whole lot instead of just a little bit to reach for an object. And that's because of where the tumor was in the back part of his brain.
So what I like him to do is use his eyes and his finger to coordinate the movement to get one fish. It's a very difficult task to do, isn't it?
So, Nathan is having a problem with figuring out where his feet are when he's walking. So that's why we're doing walking in therapy, to help him sort of get the connection back so that he knows where his foot's going. Good. Okay, there you go. Whoa.
One thing that probably you notice right away is the way Nathan talks is different. Even though he's using all the words that anyone else would use, they don't sound the same, and it's harder for him to get those words to come out of his mouth and sound like the way you and I talk. So he talks slower, and sometimes it's hard to understand him. But that doesn't mean that he doesn't know what he's trying to say, and it doesn't mean that he doesn't think about what he's doing. He's doing those things, it's just that his body, which includes his face and his mouth and his tongue, aren't working as well.
Can I take a quick up? He's not a big bear fan? Oh. He's just faking me out?
He has better days than other days. Sometimes he's more talkful, some days his body goes through a lot of stuff, so he needs some more alone time. So.
Radiation will kill any cells that reproduce really fast. He has 33 treatments total, Monday through Friday. He comes in, treatment lasts maybe about 5 to 7 minutes, and then he's done. We send him back up to his room, and he comes back the next day. Say my fist is a tumor, it's a pretty big tumor, but it's floating in space, and we have lasers to line up to these marks. The doctor tells us where to mark everything, and that pinpoints where the tumor is, and the machine and everything rotates around for treatment. Nathan is one of our ideal patients. It's hard. Going through this is a very, very hard process, emotionally and physically. And to be here 6 to 8 weeks and away from home, that's really tough. But the attitude of the parents really kind of shows in the patients, and so mom's been really great, and Nathan's been a trooper, and he's been doing good.
So a little bit earlier, Dr. Hautrau talked about the different treatments that Nathan is getting. She talked about chemotherapy and radiation, and both of those have some side effects. And so you might notice when you see Nathan that his hair is a little bit splotchy or that he's missing parts of it. And over time, once Nathan stops these treatments, his hair will begin to grow back. So besides just working hard at therapy and getting his treatments, Nathan has also been able to use some of the spaces that we have just for kids here at the hospital. We have a school room where kids can come and do their schoolwork, and we also have an all-star technology room that has things like computers and video games that he could check his email or play the newest game.
So sometimes when kids go back to school and their body works differently than it did before, it can be challenging for the other kids in the classroom to know how to treat them. But Nathan is really very capable of telling you what's important to him and expressing himself. So you should treat Nathan like you treated him before. He's the same kid. It's just that his body works differently than it did before. And he's experienced a lot of challenges recently. So sometimes if he can't do something by himself, he might need special assistance. And the good news is Nathan's really good at instructing people on how to help him. And so if you feel like you want to help Nathan, you should feel comfortable doing it. And helping Nathan is a way that you can show him what a good friend you are.
I sat down with Nathan and talked to him about the things that he would like you guys to help him with. Let's call these Nathan's do's and don'ts. And the things he would like you to help him with is helping him carrying his books between classes, helping him play out on the schoolyard by pushing his wheelchair, also helping him carry his lunch tray at lunch, and getting him drinks so that he can stay hydrated throughout the day. So there's also things that Nathan doesn't want you to help him with. So he doesn't want you to make fun of him when he's at school. He wants you to treat him just like he was before. He also, with his wheelchair, he only wants one person at a time to help him push his wheelchair, and you must always ask him before you push or touch his wheelchair.
I have to say I'm very proud of Nathan for making this video, because this video is going to help lots of people understand the experience so that they have some idea about what it's like to have a tumor in the brain and get the treatment for that tumor, and also what it's like to go through the process of recovery knowing that your body has changed and that you have to do things differently than you did before.
So now that you know where Nathan has been over the last few months, you guys are the experts. You know why he was in the hospital, what he's been doing in the hospital, and you guys can help at school to tell other kids. He's been in the hospital for several months and he's been working really hard just to get back to school. You guys are Team Nathan, and you're gonna be able to help him and support him when he comes back to you at school.